In 180 BC, an emperor came into power. An emperor who only cared for his own selfish desires had neglected his responsibilities as an emperor. He thought himself equal to gods such as Hercules, wore clothes that consisted of lion skin, and carried a club. He had flings with about 300 women and boys. He was a gladiator, an emperor, and a contribution to the death of Rome. His name was Lucius Aurelius Commodus Antonius.
You could hear.
Commodus was a gladiator even when he was an emperor. This was a controversy because the citizens could not believe that their emperor would willingly reduce himself to being the lowest human being on earth. The emperor claimed to be the best, but people knew that the fights were unfair. The men and beasts that Commodus fought were inadequately armed and armored, as seen here. Commodus is being armed to the teeth while his opponent gets a sword.
And now for the main event, what you've all been waiting for, Commodus versus Ahmed! Be grateful you were about to die at the hands of the Emperor.
I, who am about to die, salute you.
Begin!
Zing, tang, slam, a bam! Oh no! My sword! Now he has the golden sword. Sing, sing, sing.
Commodus is a loser.
Commodus' own sister conspired against him, because it was clear that Commodus was mentally unstable. After Commodus discovered this treachery, he exiled his sister to an island, and after a while, killed her along with the others involved. This is what happened after Commodus learned of this conspiracy.
Oh, hey, Commodus.
And Commodus also killed his sister. Another instance of Commodus' brutality comes from an event which the emperor ordered the killing of a whole city. This was the effect of a citizen giving him an unfriendly look. As already stated, this led to the massacre of an unlucky city.
Son, no, but my children.
Your children are orphans now.
As Commodus went mad with power, he took the privileges to the max. He renamed months to his own selfish desire. He changed the name of Rome to Colonial Commodiana, which means Colony of Commodus. He changed the Senate's name to Commodian Fortunate Senate, after himself. So many things I can do.
Guard! Guard!
Yes, sir.
Kill the prisoners outside. I'm sick of them dying in my cells.
Yes, sir.
Skeller!
Yes, sire. What will you have me do for you, old great emperor?
Change the months. I'm sick of them.
To what, sire?
I don't know. Something that relates with Commodus.
Anything else, sire?
Yes. Let me think for a minute. Write a script on my accomplishments.
Is there anything else you would have me to do?
How about this? Go meet with the Senate and change the name of Rome to Colonial Commodiana.
Yes, sir.
I had a good night, Marcia.
Yes, me too. That dinner was excellent. Okay, I better get going.
All right, goodbye.
Goodbye, give me a kiss.
Commodus' main lover, Marcia, leaves Commodus' chamber to meet with Commodus' wrestling partner to plan his murder.
Hello. Hi. You're my lover's wrestling partner, right? Yes, I am. Okay, well, how are you gonna do this? I'm gonna sneak into his bed and then strangle him. Okay, that's a good idea.
Marcia then lets Commodus' wrestling partner in, and he goes to Commodus.
Your time has come. What are you talking about? God! It's not over yet.
Contribution to the death of Rome. Good night, Lucius, Aurelius, Commodus, Antonius.
It kills me not to know this, but I've all but just forgotten what the color of her eyes were, and her scars, or how she got them. As the telling signs of age rain down, a single tear is dropping through the valleys of an aging face that this world has forgotten. That will put me in my place, and there is no time like a present to drink these drained seconds. Sell them to these words ring true, and I'm constantly failing you. Walls that we just can't break through until it disappears. So tell me now, to say love, and how do we get it out? So I don't know. That's when she said, I don't hate you, but I just want to save you while there's still something left.
It's pretty good. How about you?
Just off the camera.
Oh,
Bye!